con The Boat Show a Porto Cervo. Siamo qui
with The Boat Show in Porto Cervo. We are here for the Swan Cup and it is a particular episode. In fact, the shipyard based in Finland celebrates its 50th anniversary. 50 years of activity from the first boat, Tarantella, built in 1966. The organization of regattas is from the yacht club Costa Smeralda. There are 125 participants from different classes.
Essere arrivati ai 50 anni è una bella tappa. Credo che la prima cosa che mi viene in mente è dare un tributo alle tante persone che hanno.
Arriving to 50 years is a beautiful stage. I think the first thing that comes to mind is to give a tribute to the many people who helped make Nauta's Swan a credible brand. I often think with gratitude to the many boat builders in Finland, to the many engineers, technicians, also in many parts of the world, as well as many owners, their crews, skippers, somehow have allowed a continuous evolution of what was the vision of the founder, Pekka Koskenkylä, 50 years ago, and above all, of the values that this vision represented, incorporated.
Da parte mia non ho mai provato un rammarico sulla decisione presa 18 anni fa di acquistare il cantiere. A quell'epoca pensavo.
For my part, I have never felt regret from the decision I made 18 years ago to buy the shipyard. At that time, I wanted, as a challenge, to bring the company into the third millennium and reaching the 50th anniversary with respect for these values and just focusing on the consistency of company growth is certainly a source of pride and also of honor.
Mi viene da aggiungere anche che è un momento molto speciale per l'azienda. C'è.
I should also add that it is a very special moment for the company. There is an energy that I have never seen before, a positive energy, with great determination to bring this company towards its objectives, which are to lead the world of boats, the world of sailing, and as always, be the company that looks forward, that looks to the future.
C'è senz'altro un denominatore comune. Io credo che sia la cultura che esiste.
There is certainly a common denominator. I think that it is the culture that exists in Finland, which exists in the technicians, in the shipyard workers, who put an extraordinary level of pride and competence into everything that they do. And this makes it possible, perhaps, to move forward always with great equilibrium of those three forces, which then, through their calibration, determine the Swan philosophy. We're talking about performance, we're talking about elegance, and as always, we're talking about a great level of reliability.
Enrico, una vita in barca.
Enrico, a lifetime boating. You started on dinghies, but even then there were the swans. What did they mean to you?
E quando andavo in barca anch'io, gli swan li guardavo, non lo so, non li avevo capiti fino in fondo quando andavo in deriva. Dal momento in cui però mi sono avvicinato.
When I was sailing dinghies, I was seeing the swans, but I didn't understand them completely. From the moment, however, that I started to get closer to the shipyard with Leonardo after he had bought it, very quickly I understood what they really were and why they were so famous. First of all, they are unique quality, but more precisely, they are a way of experiencing the sea, a way of living the sea, made with passion, made with respect, made precisely with, as you see here in Porto Cervo, at the Rolex Swan Cup, a, how do you say, a community that respects the sea, that loves their boats in a unique way. What should we expect for the future?
Ma come sai, l'evoluzione in realtà non si ferma mai, per cui come, così come questo cantiere.
As you know, evolution actually never stops. So this shipyard, this brand, has evolved over time from the Swan Tarantella 36 of Sparkman and Stevens to the Swan 115, which is present here in Porto Cervo. We can definitely expect other changes related to design and technology.
Noi, da un punto di vista strategico, ci stiamo rivolgendo a due principali novità. Il ritorno alle barche medie.
We form a strategic point of view. We are targeting two main innovations. The return to medium boats with the Swan 50 and Swan 54, the Swan 65 that we just launched, and the Swan 78, and perhaps some other smaller boat.
e invece questo grossissimo investimento nelle barche grandi con gli swan.
And on the other, this very big investment in large boats with Swan 115, and maybe we will also see a few boats that are perhaps even bigger. We have many projects on the drawing board that we are developing as super yachts.
Ho lavorato per Nautor per più della metà della mia carriera.
I worked for Nautor's more than half of my design career. It was always a very stimulating and dynamic experience.
Molto stimolante e dinamica. Questo è stato per me un'opportunità.
It was an opportunity for me to create these boats that will last for years, will become classics.
Diventeranno classici. Sicuramente la prima, il 51, è stato un grande successo.
And certainly the first, the 51, has been a great success. The 46, the 46 that I designed, of which more than 100 were built.
E poi queste ultime barche più moderne hanno avuto una evoluzione importante.
Then these latest, more modern boats that were built, that have undergone an important evolution. They have changed. They are not just blue waters for cruisers, but for people who want to have fun, maybe younger, with a bit more active lifestyle.
Quando io ho cominciato la mia vita di architetto navale, le barche più grandi erano 72 piedi, oggi sono 70 metri, stanno arrivando.
When I started my life as a naval architect, the biggest boats were around 72 feet. Today, they are coming up to 70 meters. And this is due a little to economic improvement after the war, and also the fact that the boats are a bit of a dream.
Gli iscritti sono 125. La Swan Cup non è solo.
There are 125 participants. The Swan Cup is not just a race, it's a way to stay together. The Swan owners are indeed one big family. The bigger ones are the Maxis, where the 115s battle it out and make a great show. A class is dedicated to boats designed by the American firm Sparkman and Stevens. There are 35. The Swan 45 have their own world championship within the Swan Cup. I believe that it is very rare, if not unique, to have together in the water 125 swans, which represent, in a tangible way, the story of these last 50 years for Swan.
Abbiamo il Tarantella, il primo Swan, sul quale c'è una storia molto speciale del suo restauro fatto su basi volontarie.
We have the Tarantella, the first Swan, which has a very special story about its restoration, which was done by volunteers of boat owners, the same builders who had constructed it 50 years before, and the Club Swan 50, which is the last boat launched to date. And in between, there is 50 years of visible history throughout the various models, from Sparkman and Stevens, Ron Holland, and the last 37 years of the Swan made by German Freyrs, all here, visible in the water.
Mi viene da aggiungere anche che è un momento molto speciale per l'azienda.
I want to also add that it is a very special moment for the company in recent times because of the approaching celebration of the 50th. We worked a lot on the history, the archives. We have made a remarkable book on the history of yachts, sailing the last 50 years, just as seen through the eyes of the Swan.
Sensazioni di un armatore.
From an owner's standpoint, what does it mean to be here at the Swan Cup?
Un bellissimo evento, eccezionale la varietà delle barche che si trova questa.
It's a beautiful event. It is exceptional, the variety of boats found here on the 50th anniversary this year, and to find myself in front of the first Swan that had been produced. It's beautiful. One comes here to participate in this great celebration, but then the spirit of competition takes over. It's a bit like this, yes?
Questo è vero in una parte, che anche noi siamo spinti di arrivare con il nostro equipaggio che è composto solo di giovani.
This is true in part. We too are pushed to arrive with our crew that consists only of young people, students of Southampton or other fans, to reach further than our resources allow.
Il nostro drive di creare da questi giovani un equipaggio
Our drive is to create a crew from these young people that manages to get in the top positions and not just leave it to the professionals, but to show that a young enthusiast is just as valuable. Sleeper is a Swan 48, designed by the American studio Sparkman and Stevens, a legendary studio in which a special classification within the Swan Cup is designated. Sleeper is one of the protagonists, and it is also one of the boats that have built the legend of this brand. Here, her line is unmistakable. That's what we all remember when it comes to the Swan. Swan 65, a legendary boat. How does it feel to be the owner?
Onorato innanzitutto. Onorato perché è una barca tutt'oggi.
Honored. Above all, honored, because it is still a spectacular boat, beautiful, both when cruising and when racing, which has given us great satisfaction. There are many of you on Sparkman and Stevens boats, as you have created an association and you feel a bit like a family, if not an elite.
Assolutamente sì, una grossa soddisfazione nel correre appunto insieme.
Absolutely, a great satisfaction in running, of course, along with this family, of 65 in particular. I believe that there are seven here, so it was beautiful, almost a match race because we were ahead of the fleet. Normally, and was a continuous tailing, spectacular regattas. The future has already begun.
Abbiamo una quantità di progetti molto importanti che vanno prima di tutto dal Club Swan 50. Dal 65 che abbiamo presentato.
We have a lot of very important projects ranging primarily from Club Swan 50, the 65 that we present in these days, the 78 which is already in advanced construction, and some big boats that we were planning right now with the significant lengths of 130 and 140 foot. This Swan 50 is a boat intended for this occasion, 50 feet long, 50 years of construction activities. It's a thoroughbred, it's fast. These days has reached 20 knots, but retains the simplicity of elements. In fact, it's quite easy to handle, even for amateur sailors.
Navigando sul Cordileone, il Cap Swan 50, mi sono veramente divertito.
Sailing on the Cordileone, the Club Swan 50, I really enjoyed myself. It was years since I felt such an experience, a boat so fast, so powerful, especially when it reached and exceeded 20 knots downwind with code zero, with an emotion I had not felt for so many years. It was really a very special race.
The way I like to see sailboats is a means or an instrument to access some feelings and some sensations that can only be achievable sailing or yachting. Sailing in this way is very unique. There's no other discipline or sport that could allow you to access these feelings. So I don't, from that principle, I don't think there is a fundamental difference between a boat that goes fast or a boat that goes slow. At the end of the day, it's about accessing some feelings and emotions that only a sailboat can do. In the case of the Club Swan 50, we have tilted those sensations and emotions that one can perceive towards a more sporty and a more racing type of boat. Nautor Swan is obviously, throughout the years, has developed an incredible craftsmanship and quality in the way they build their boats. Now this also translates, not always, but often, translates into weight, and so we, with the Club Swan 50, we sort of challenge each other to be able to remain with the quality and the craftsmanship that is expected from a company like Nautor Swan, but at the same time to do it light enough for it to be performant.
It's been a week of challenging sailing, so many Swan, a lot of news, but this Maestro was the protagonist. It has been blowing up to 40 knots, which has been a joy to the photos, but unfortunately has caused some of the races to be cancelled.